Welcome all to this masterclass with Professor Pierluigi Parcu, Director of the Center for Media Pluralism and Media Freedom at the European University Institute based in Florence, Italy. My name is Julia Madrazo. I'm Policy Manager at the Forum on Information and Democracy, and I'll have the honor of interviewing Professor Parcu. Professor Parcu is the chair of the Forum's Working Group on Pluralism of News and Information in Curation and Indexation Algorithms. Professor Parcu, thank you for being here today and for guiding us through these important topics of pluralism and its impact on democracy. So, to start off, thank you. To start off, how do we define pluralism?
Well, the definition of media pluralism has been studied for a long time. We have two general view of pluralism, two general ways in which we can look at this. As a representative pluralism, that is the idea that media have to mirror the society and be a marketplace of ideas. So they should give a full representation of the situation of the society. And then there is another view that is not a contradiction, is complementary to this, that is that media pluralism is a sort of deliberative pluralism, in which media operate as a sort of public forum, in which they play an active role in the formation and the creation of public opinion. Both of these roles represent and help the formation of the public forums are part of the concept of media pluralism, the way in which we intend it in general.
Thank you. Thank you for that framework. And how, what are the differences between internal and external pluralism?
Well, these are clearly the two categories. Operational categories, let's say, that we use for media pluralism. Internal pluralism is this idea that media should have some ability to have a content diversity in themselves, in which they represent a variety of content, of viewpoints, of social representation, experiences, so that even a single media outlet has an ability to express a complexity. Clearly, this is less true for normal private single media, more important for public service media, where public service media have a sort of mission to have a sort of internal pluralism, to be able to express a plurality of content, to be also, if you want, cultural media, to give a cultural view of what they are, the information that they are telling to the people. Then external pluralism is a different concept, is the idea that the media market has a diversity of voices, of sources of information, of ownership, of streams of financing, so that we have a plurality of voice in the market. So the idea is that both these elements join together in delivering what we were calling before a representative view of society through a plurality of voices, a plurality of sources, and also an ability of these voices, of these sources, to be able to express a cultural articulated view, a content diversity. And particularly in the case of public service media, for which this role is essential.
Okay, and balancing this internal and external pluralism, why is pluralism overall important for democracy? Why would you say balancing of voices is important for democracy?
Yes, balancing of voice is important for democracy because we need to have democracy as the expression of an informed debate, and pluralism can help this. But let me say that besides and before internal and external pluralism, together with them, in this very moment, another element is becoming important. It is essential for democracy, and this the exposure diversity. The fact that in a world of digital platforms in which the legacy media are not the main anymore, we'll discuss this in a second, the main instrument of, or the only instrument, or even the main instrument of information spreading, well, it's important that it is in this digital world in which there are so many sources, there is not only content diversity, but is the possibility to discover, to give prominence to the content that is important for that role we were discussing before, to form in the public debate, to form in the, to respond to the public interest, to give the important information. So, but then let's, if we talk about always media pluralism and its role on social, for democracy, we have to look at this in several dimensions. For instance, we run this Media Pluralism Monitor, that is an instrument to gather the information about the European Union and other countries, but is used also in other countries beside the European Union. Our method is the idea that we want to see media pluralism in different dimensions, and we look at a series of dimensions. Media pluralism is the result of several things. The fundamental protection, how the legal system protects pluralism, the media, the independence of the media authorities, internet access for people, and all these things. The way in which there is a market plurality, the discussion we were doing about external pluralism before, the importance of having many voices, and many voices that are independent one from each other, financed from different sources, owned by different people. That's an important element that we also study. Then there is very essential the political independence, the fact that these voices are independent, these media voices are independent from the political, for the political arena, because if media have to be the watchdog of democracy, if they have to look at what happened in politics, they have to, they have to be independent. And then finally, and that's what we were discussing before, media have to express society. So social inclusiveness is fundamental. The fact that media are able to represent the society in all these characteristics, and particularly they are able to represent the gender situation, the local community, the disabilities, to offer a view of the society that is fair from all the components. This is very important. So in essence, media pluralism is a sort of basis for democracy, forms public opinion, helps informed choice, and guarantees the diversity of choice and the openness of debate. Media pluralism and democracy are very strictly linked.
And so why is pluralism important for the information ecosystem as a whole, not only democracy?
Well, if we look at media pluralism and the media ecosystem, we have different elements here that we have to consider. First, as we were discussing, we want a plurality of views. This is important for democracy, but important for society in general, that all the views can be expressed. Second, we need the reliable sources of information. And this is true for our life, not only for democracy. We want good, reliable sources of information about pandemics. We want reliable sources of information about wars. We want reliable sources of information about the evolution of science. Society lives and thrives if it has reliable sources of information. Information is important for democracy, but it's important for a social democratic life more in general. Then, as I said, we want a public watchdog activity by the media, because we want that politics is controlled, that corruption is contrasted, that the judiciary is independent, that there is somebody that looks after the problems and try to find them and expose them if they are there. And then obviously we need a well-functioning market for media if we want all this to happen. The problem here is that this idea of media at the service of democracy, at the service of a well-functioning society, is in a special moment, because the legacy media are at the moment under the pressure of a lot of different forces. Clearly, networks that are critical for the development of the digital economy are helping to distribute media and information in different ways than in the past. Then there is a lot of innovation, and this innovation is also changing the way in which people can communicate, user-generated content is born, users can also create news, and that's a new element. And then there is, and we'll discuss it a little bit more, the issue of the business model of the platform that is shaping competitive dynamics and is putting in serious jeopardy the legacy media. So we have a very important tension here between the past and the future, and the present situation is a situation of serious difficulty for legacy media. And then the final element is that all this needs to be evolving, considering a world in which privacy, freedom of enterprise, freedom of expression, pluralism of information, all these fundamental rights need to be balanced in a world that is changing very rapidly. And so the role that we were asking for media in relation to democracy, it remains extremely important, but in a world that is changing very rapidly, in which they are under very important pressure, and we can discuss these pressures.